Quasars are the most energetic objects in the universe. They're so bright, they can be seen from across the universe, and so distant that they take us back to a time when the universe was very young. Now astronomers using the Hubble Space Telescope have found the brightest quasar in the early universe, an object 600 trillion times the intensity of the sun. At least that's what it appeared to be at first. The reality turns out to be far more interesting. Welcome back to Launchpad. I'm Christian Reddy, your friendly neighborhood astronomer. At the 233rd meeting of the American Astronomical Society, a team of astronomers announced the discovery of the most powerful quasar ever found in the early universe. Now, suffice to say, this created a lot of news, but I think something important got lost in the translation. And that's a shame because I think the reality of this story is actually much more interesting than what's being reported. Now, before we get into the story, let's just talk briefly about what quasars are in general so that we're all on the same page. All galaxies have supermassive black holes at their centers. And by supermassive, we mean anywhere from several million to billions of times the mass of our sun. So they're called supermassive for a good reason. As matter from the surrounding galaxy falls inward toward the black hole, it forms a superheated whirlpool of plasma called an accretion disk. The accretion disk is no larger than the solar system, yet it outshines the entire surrounding galaxy. They release so much energy into the surrounding galaxy that they can generate thousands of new stars every year. By comparison, our Milky Way creates less than one star a year. Because quasars are so bright, they can be seen from across the universe. But because light moves at a finite speed, we see the quasars as they appeared billions of years ago. But the universe is expanding, carrying the distant galaxies and quasars away from us. This means that the farther away a galaxy or quasar is from Earth, the more its light is stretched out to longer or redder wavelengths. This stretching of the light to red wavelengths is called redshift, and astronomers can measure a quasar's redshift to quickly get an idea of how far away it is and therefore how far back into the past they are looking. The quasars in the early universe were fairly bright, but they actually got a little bit brighter as time went on. So by the time the universe was, say, a few billion years old, the quasars were enjoying a kind of a cosmic heyday. So imagine the surprise a team of astronomers had when they discovered an ultra-bright quasar at a redshift when the universe was less than a billion years old. Now, we're going to talk about this discovery in just a moment, but first, I want to thank my Patreon supporters for their generous support. Patty Broussard, Neil from Crypto Cruising, Eric from Modern Day Family Man, and I'm delighted to welcome my three new supporters, John Cannon, Aaron Wilson, and Garoth Balayan. Thank you so much for your generous support. A team led by Xiaohui Fan at the University of Arizona noticed a high-redshift quasar in the Sloan Digital Sky Survey. The quasar is called J043947.08 plus 163415.7. Rolls right off the tongue, doesn't it? Let's just call it Joe 439 for short. Anyway, this quasar was discovered at a redshift of 6.5, which places it a little less than a billion years after the Big Bang. So this is a very high redshift early universe quasar. Quasars of this epoch in the early universe had luminosities of tens of trillions of times our sun. That's still very bright, but J0439 clocked in at something like 600 trillion times the sun. That would make J439 the brightest quasar in the early universe. But was it really as bright as it seemed? Fan and his team wondered if there was, in fact, a kind of natural magnifying effect at work here. Specifically, they suspected a gravitational lens. A gravitational lens is a prediction of Einstein's theory of general relativity, which states that a sufficiently massive object, such as a galaxy, that's placed between us and a background object will bend the light from the background object around it, boosting the brightness and intensity of the background object and allowing us to inspect the background object in greater detail than would otherwise be possible. Quasars have been studied through gravitational lenses before, but they always happen to be at relatively lower redshift, which puts them a few billion years after the Big Bang. J0439, however, was at a much higher redshift, which would put it less than a billion years after the Big Bang. So they examined the object through several large ground-based telescopes. They were able to determine that the object was a little bit extended on the sky, which suggested maybe there was a gravitational lens at play here, but it wasn't until they used the Hubble Space Telescope that they finally distinguished a foreground galaxy that was lensing the quasar into three separate images. The foreground galaxy's gravitational lens boosted the background quasar's brightness from 11 trillion to an apparent 600 trillion times the luminosity of our sun. That's a factor of 50 increase in brightness. That makes J0439 the highest redshifted quasar, and therefore the earliest quasar ever viewed through a strong gravitational lens. This means astronomers now have a powerful new window into this quasar's early past and can probe the quasar and its surrounding environment in unprecedented detail. And the other cool thing is that this is a completely serendipitous discovery. They weren't expecting to find such highly redshifted quasars that would be strongly gravitationally lensed. If they stumbled upon the J0439 gravitational lens, perhaps there are other early universe quasars that are also being strongly gravitationally lensed. So no, it's not that this quasar is 600 trillion times brighter than our sun in real life. Rather, it's merely 11 trillion times brighter than the sun. But the fact that we're seeing this through a gravitational lens at such a high redshift is new territory for us. And now we have a new window into the early universe. Now, if you'd like to learn a little bit more about quasars, I'll have some videos posted to them here and in the description below. And if you would like to join me on this journey through this amazing universe of ours, please make sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any new videos. Until next time, stay curious, my friends.